and that I wanted to have some resolution for the family.
Volunteers work around the clock in an effort to find the missing boy.
They were here from sunrise to sunset. So if they weren't physically able to go out there to search, they still gave us support in some way or the other.
As Sean's parents hold out hope, authorities begin the task of contacting and questioning sex offenders in the area.
During the investigation, I actually found out a number of suspects, and you do in any case like this, but none of it proved out.
There wasn't anything new happening, no one had found anything, there was no evidence, so it just got harder and harder.
And their frustration turns to despair as the search party's numbers dwindle with time.
We were really getting worried that we were going to get abandoned. You know, while we understood that they can't stay there and search forever, and that our volunteers can't be here forever, they have a job, they have a family, they have responsibilities, you know, it still felt like we were getting abandoned and we were being left on our own.
In the meantime, investigators have to consider all the reasons someone may have taken Sean.
In 1970, if a child was abducted, you assume it was a